Guys, in this video I'm going to show you how to build a cat hut. Now I've done such a video I think a couple of years ago, and the hut back then was okay, but like it required a lot of work and was very required a lot of material. It was very, you know, time and work intensive. So I came up with a much simpler and yet more effective concept for a cat hut. And the first part you need for a cat hut is basically such a cover. Painters use that kind of cover to cover furniture and stuff before they paint any walls and ceilings. And this kind of cover is like nylon. It's quite thick. Pick the thickest you can get to avoid tears. And that cover is going to cover the whole hut once it's done. Now, the second part of the hut is basically an inner box. Basically, it looks like that when you get it. That's how it looks when you get it. Just a normal carton or box, cardboard box. And what you do, you just fold that box and stick it, you know, stick it together. And you get something like that. So it's basically sealed with duct tape. And just sealed it like as if I'm gonna send that as a package. And then what I did, I cut an opening with a cutter, something like that, simple cutter, and I cut an opening of 16 times 16 centimeters for the cat to come in and out. Now, 16 centimeters, a square of 16 centimeters is more than enough for any cat. Like my experience was, I mean, judging from my experience, 16 centimeters was more than enough for any cat. And this box is around 40 centimeters wide. Let me put it this way. It's basically 40 centimeters wide, 40 centimeters long, and 30 centimeters high. And that size is more than enough for a cat, because I noticed that cats do not consume more than 40 times 40 centimeters when they're lying. You can measure that. Pick any chair where a cat sits and you can measure that chair and see it doesn't require more than that. Allow for some extra space, because that inner box is going to be filled with straw. So basically, you have straw all over the place here. So when the cat goes in, it's like in a straw tunnel. And that straw gives it an added insulation against the cold. So that's why you gotta fill that up with straw, otherwise it's quite useless as a shelter. Right, so that's the inner box, that's where the cat goes in. And I got like a box like that, cost like €2 in Europe. I don't know worldwide what it costs, but it's not much, like €2 for such a box. I got like 15 of these. Now, the second component the third component would be a bigger box. And this bigger box would then contain that inner box. So that bigger box makes out the outer space of that hut. And you put the inner box in it. And what happens then is that in that empty space, you put a lot of styrofoam. But before we got to that stage, the dimensions of the outer box depend on how much space do you want to give to that styrofoam. So in my case, for instance, I needed at least 10 centimeters here and 10 centimeters here for my styrofoam. Over here, I got more than enough space for my styrofoam, but width-wise, I needed at least 10 centimeters on each side for my styrofoam, because styrofoam is that material which insulates the whole inner box from the cold outside. And the dimensions of the outer box are 80 centimeters times 60 times 60. Right, so it's basically 80 long, 60 wide, and 60 high. And you need that extra width, height, and length, because we come to the next component, which is basically the styrofoam. It comes in a lot of plates like that. You can buy that from any DIY store. Comes in plates like that. Here you got a whole bunch of, I got all this lot for I think 20 euros. And these are like 5 centimeter thick. What you do, you measure the internals of the outer box, and then you cut the styrofoam accordingly, and you just place it, and obviously I didn't cut it now, but you just place it like that. So basically, you see here, I need enough space to put two plates on this side and two plates on this side. This way I get like 10 centimeter styrofoam on each side. And at the back, I have the luxury of putting more styrofoam back here. So, and of course, don't forget, you put at the bottom and at the top also. So basically at the bottom, you put that styrofoam like that. Obviously you cut it so it fits in the box. I put two layers, basically 10 centimeters at the bottom and 10 centimeters at the top. You can also put more depending on the size of your outer box. That's why make sure you got enough space. Make sure you got an outer box big enough to hold that extra styrofoam. And and then once you're done, so you got everything is filled up with styrofoam, don't put any styrofoam in front of that opening, because then you would have to cut all that styrofoam. That's a huge mess. What you do, just put some, you're gonna get a lot of, through cutting, by cutting the styrofoam, you're gonna get a lot of waste material like that, right? So what you do, you just place it here, place it like this. You're gonna get several of these waste plate residues, and just place them like that. Let me just show you. Just place one next to the other like this, and the other side as well, one on top of the other, and so you've got a sort of a tunnel. Let me get another one just to show you. So here I've, like you see now, I've placed a lot of waste plate rests or residues into that place. So I covered that whole area of that opening to the side of the outer box. Okay, it's very difficult to get here. Yeah, now I got it. Right, and now once you got that, now I can, let me just go in the camera like this. Now once I got that, now I can cut the opening for the outer box for the cat to go in. So I can cut here, the opening here. What I would also suggest is don't cut the opening so it's like, so it leads directly to the opening of the inner box, but offset it for a bit. Just place it, let me take them some stuff off. Just offset it a bit to one side, so that if there's a gust of wind, the gust of wind doesn't blow directly to the inner box. If you do it, if you put the opening of the outer box straight in front of the opening for the inner box, you could have gusts of wind blowing through and stuff like that. So basically what I would advise, offset, for instance, the opening of the outer box to one side, and if you wish, the opening of the inner box to the other side. So this way you've got a certain angle. It's not easy for wind to come in. Obviously, you've got to have this angle free for the cat to come in and out, but it sure ensures that there's no wind or rain coming in directly into the inner section. Right, so that's the work you gotta do. Basically, you cut this styrofoam to fit in here, and then once you're done, let me just remove those bits. Once you're done, you just close the outer box. You just close the outer box and tape it with duct tape. You tape it with duct tape, and then after that, so it looks like that. Obviously, yours would have then an opening here, and then you fold that painter cover around the whole box and tape it, and this way you got a cool cat hut. Don't forget, once you cover that hut with this painter cover, cut a part of that cover over here so the cat would have access to the inside. And also make sure on the inside that all the styrofoam is quite stable. So basically you would have something like this on the one side, something like that on the other side, and between them maybe another piece like this stabilizes the whole stuff. I think the most of the work is over here, but you can, if you cut smartly your styrofoam, you could use a lot of those residues to do this area. And I mean, I use like 1, 2, 3, 4. I use maybe like 6 plates, 7 plates for one hut. 7 such plates for one hut. I always get 1 plate left over. And so, you know, just see to it that you cut it smartly and don't waste a lot of styrofoam. And yeah, that's about it. And of course, then when you're done, the hut is done and you want to place it then in its destination, what I would advise you, take some of your styrofoam residuals and just use them as sort of legs and place the hut on those legs. So this way the hut is not in direct contact with the ground and does not lose heat to that ground. Just put on some legs, or if you get anything else, on some sort of wooden blocks you don't need, just make sure it doesn't wobble. And you got yourself a decent hut.